Good morning, everyone. Thank you very much for joining me. I really appreciate every one of you, those in our community of like-minded people. Yeah, really help out in sharing the videos and thumbing up, making sure they're still subscribed, even when YouTube, for some reason, mistakenly unsubscribes people. Today is Sunday, January 29th, 2023. I seen an article about an earthquake that was felt in the Brewton, Alabama area. Over 1,000 people said they felt some shaking, and those there at the University of Alabama and USGS said no, there was no earthquake, even though there was so many reports. So I downloaded a monitor from that location, and you can see, in fact, there is an earthquake here, and it is marked in red, meaning the computer picked it up and sent a notification to whoever would be responsible for this monitor. Now, this monitor here is BRAL BHZ. This earthquake was on Friday, January 27th, and there's the earthquake signature that I extracted from the stream view. The report, just by the act of God that I found, was on NorthEscambia.com news. They said the earthquake that people reported came in at 11:09 a.m. And you can see right here, yep, 11:09. But for some reason, they are saying this is not an earthquake when in fact it was. Said they had received over 1,000 reports, and 911 operators also took several reports. The event was recorded at an official seismic monitor in Brewton, Alabama at 11:09. And this is what they posted for the paper there. Then it goes on to say that the Geological Survey of Alabama Geologic Investigation Program Director Sandy Elbersole, PhD, reviewed the data along with USGS and told North Escambia, sorry for pronouncing that wrong, .com that it was not an earthquake. The data is messy and noisy, she said. It definitely does not have an earthquake signature. I'm sorry, you are wrong. It was probably stronger than what I came up with. I gave them the benefit of the doubt, and this is a spectrogram right here. But it comes in as a magnitude 2.35. You can see it at the bottom, MD 2.35. We'll go to the seismic signature here. Right there. Okay. Yeah, there was two strong peaks, which you can see here on the stream view. Let me make that bigger for you. I'll bring it across right there. Yeah, it started out small, and then it popped, and then it popped again. I cannot tell you how deep it was, but it does show the frequency hertz from one, well, if we go up to the top of the rattling, maybe 16. But actually within, let me try this here, 1 to 6 hertz it looks like. And I'll extract that. See how it started out small and then it popped? There's actually two poppings there. And then it came in larger. Let me extract that. See, that is harmonic tremors. Yeah, do you guys have any volcanoes in your area? Now, we do know that with the core of the Earth either stopping or reversing its flow, that we're going to be seeing a lot more earthquakes with the coming magnetic pole reversal. The continents will move. They moved the last time there was a magnetic pole reversal. That was even published in Time magazine about the Earth's core stopping, slowing down, and reversing. All these ancient faults are being reactivated of late, and those of you that follow me know that. But anyways, we don't want to go into things that people might consider conspiracy theory, even though it's not. Like I said, it was in Time Magazine and other science journals about that. So why would they either be being mistaken or deliberately lie about this earthquake? Like I said, it was at least a magnitude 2.21. And I don't really see anything else. I'll bring it down. Let's take a look at what it's been showing when I pulled the files earlier this morning. Let's go up to here. Yeah. Now, let me go back to Google Earth. This is the location of all the reports. I'll show you the reports of people, what they said, what they felt. The paper had over 55 responses. This one says, I was lying in bed because of work overnight. I was wakened by the shaking. At first, I thought it was a sonic boom because it felt like the house was being pushed. It might sound crazy, maybe. It just may be. It could be a sign since it wasn't just felt in Florida by two other different states. Yeah, there's been reports in Florida, but I looked there and I haven't seen any earthquakes in Florida. And they have felt earthquakes in the past from Georgia and Alabama. But then there's another one says, I have been at Edwards Air Force Base when the shuttle was returning. The sound of the double sonic boom sounded very similar to what I heard and felt. I agree with an earlier poster that said space junk or something entering the Earth's atmosphere is a very likely possibility. Thousands of people don't feel and hear their imagination. No, this was not your imagination. Another report said, I just laid down for a light mid-morning rest. I heard my roof pop and my windows rattle. My dog's ears stood up. He growled. It felt like a plane was going to hit our house. It was pretty scary. They don't give an exact location. I would like to know where that was at. I've never felt anything like that while living in Florida, so this must have come from Florida. I have been in earthquake in Mexico and Oregon. It felt like that to me. It was definitely intense. Another one here. Said they heard two booms and a rumble in Pedro Key, but didn't feel any shaking. Another one says, I was asleep at the time, but my husband definitely heard it. A very loud explosion. I had gotten reports from people in Florida about shaking and explosion. I looked at the monitors and there was nothing there. But this one in Alabama definitely shows the earthquake. Like I said, I would not have found this if it wasn't for an act of God. All right. And told me about it, their husband. He said it reverberated off all the houses around us and all the dogs in the neighborhood started barking. We are in Robertsdale, a block of Highway 90. He said it sounded as if it was coming from the south, like something big blew up. I firmly believe it was the Bavard fault. Let's see. Okay, here on Wikipedia is a, I can't make it. Can I make it bigger? There you go. The fault. Yeah, very well could have been. Let me bring this down a little bit. Here we got Montgomery. And Montgomery is north of where these earthquake reports came from. So this comes from Sue Weaver. It says, look it up. Yeah, I did. It begins in Brevard, North Carolina, ends up at Montgomery, Alabama. But a fault can grow wider and deeper. Well, there's often offshoots of it, too, and or longer. I think the fault has extended to the coast of Alabama area and the Florida Panhandle area. Yeah, it probably has. You're probably absolutely right, Sue. Or the underwater area of the coastal ocean and the Bay Areas experienced a huge shift. ready for a tsunami, anyone? The book of Revelations tells of disruptions in the sky, sea, and earth. Read it for yourself. Okay, Berrydale. A definite rumble and vibration that traveled at around 11. I looked at and checked the clock. It was unusual. All right, another one from Holly. I live in Navy Point on the northwest side where our house faces southwest, 32 degrees. I was outside edging our grass when just about the time something exploded, not a boom sound or airplane crash or anything. I could give reference to a very different sound noise that I've ever heard. Beneath my feet, the ground was lightly trembling. Some of the pavers in the driveway pulled from settling flat. Only a handful closest to the road. Then about a minute and a half, another one lightly trembled again. But the ground, I noticed and felt it rumbling southeast of my carport drive. I went inside and it was 11:01 a.m. Okay, and then we got some more reports. Let's see. Rhonda Kelly, as I commented earlier, at about 11:10 a.m. near Blue Angel Parkway and Lillian Highway, I guess that is, I wanted to add that after thinking about it, even though it did not sound like a sonic boom from a jet breaking the sound barrier, it did feel somewhat similar to when the space shuttle would make a re-entry to the atmosphere. When I lived in California, I felt that a couple of times when the trajectory towards Edwards Air Force Base meant it came in over L.A., Los Angeles. There would be two quick percussion bursts. So what I felt yesterday would have been two items making a re-entry together. Well, there was two quakes. I just showed you that. Okay, another one says, I was lying in bed next to my husband and my daughter was standing next to us. I didn't hear or feel anything, but both of them jumped up and ran outside when some of my family was trying to figure out. Up the road at my store, my manager said that when it happened, only people on the left side of my store was able to feel and hear anything. Yeah, so weird. I would agree. I'll give you a link to this and you can read all these comments, people asking if it was a bomb test. There has been reports of earthquakes that when the ground pops, it's like an explosion. And there's been reports with no earthquake reported of the sound of an explosion coming from the ground. And some people say, well, they're demolishing or building underground tunnels. Yeah, I'm going to go that route. All right, here's another report that Rhonda was probably talking about. Windows rattled, walls creaked, clear blue sky, no sound of trucks or aircraft outside was silent. Speaking with neighbors, friends, and family, I noticed people in homes facing east-west felt it on the same block. Homes facing north-south did not. Coincidence, yeah. One side of the fault went kaboom, it sounds like. Yeah. Yeah, lots of reports here. I'll give you a link unless I see something that's important. This one said they felt it in Greenville, Alabama. Robertsdale, Alabama. It was very scary for me and my two-year-old. At first, the doors and windows were rattling. It sounded as if they were going to burst open. And then it sounded like something was crashing into my house. When I walked outside, there were dogs barking facing south and neighbors trying to figure out what was going on as well. They're giving good descriptions here. Jim from Summerdale, Alabama. I live full-time in an RV. Definitely felt the RV shake twice, separated by maybe 20 to 30 seconds. Definite shake. Did not hear a sonic boom. My neighbor who lives in a house near me says they also felt the same thing. No, this definitely was an earthquake. Let me close this out. And yeah, right there. That's the largest one that I've seen here. We'll go forward another 8 hours. And another 8 hours to double check to make sure that... See, we got these slow-moving tremors. That's what that is, slow-moving tremors. We'll go ahead another 8 hours. Oh, there might be one right there. I don't know if I downloaded the data. Let me extract that. Right there. Okay. That would have been yesterday. About 1:38 p.m. Okay, let's go ahead. Let's see, let me pull this up. Clear that. Go ahead, another. Yeah, same. We got, let's see what this is over here. This is all today, Sunday. And we'll extract that, see what that is. Yeah. And that would have been today. Let's see. At about, 7:55 a.m. Yeah, I was looking up here at this one for the time that I pulled it, but you got to go down by what's showing there. Yeah. Yeah, like I said, with the weakening of the Earth's magnetic field, you just don't know. Are the continents starting to show signs of moving? And did you feel this earthquake or the other ones that I pointed out since then? Yeah, if so, please put those comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Always be prepared for a disaster. And I will talk to you later. God bless you all. Bye.